Today I will be talking about the basic deck that you get when you first install the Dragon Ball ICDB digital card game. And I had to install a clean version on my phone because I edited the Gohan deck, I believe. So I need to clear out the deck, remake it, and then we're gonna go over it and play a real game, and I'm gonna show you guys what every card does, so stay tuned. The Gohan deck, the deck you get when you start the game. A lot of basic cards. Let's go ahead and just take a look at what you get. Let's review Gohan as your leader. And this is the Gohan leader card. Let me just change the thing so you can see what I'm looking at. Like I said, I like to have this open every time I'm playing just because I'm not really good at reading kanji. So if I'm sitting there trying to figure out what the card says, while I can just do this, it's just a lot simpler. So anyway, attack skill. Almost all leader cards have this skill, so once you understand it, it's going to be very straightforward. Strike skill, activated when this card deals damage to an opponent, draw one, unleash. Unleash is basically your flip, so you can flip this card when you have four or below. It doesn't mean you have to, but you can. This is nice though. Every time you deal damage, you draw a card. And drawing cards in this game is very key, in my opinion. So we're gonna flip the card, and this is what he looks like if he flips over and becomes more powerful. Now, the one bad thing about this Gohan card as a leader is when you flip him, he only has 12,000 power. Most other leaders have 15,000. This one only has 12,000. And there's probably a reason why. His attack skill, draw one card when attacking, very standard. Again, this card gets 3,000 power. Okay, so now he's at 15, but again, his standard base power is 12,000, which is not that great. Continuous effect. If your opponent's life is 4 or above, he gets 1 strike, so he can deal 3 damage as long as your opponent has more life than you or 4 or above. My opinion, this leader card's not that great, so if you can change it as soon as possible. I will be going over other leader cards and other decks in other videos, but we're using the Gohan base deck over here. So the cards you get are very standard cards. Let's see if any cards have any effects that you might not understand, and we can go over them. So it looks like there are no special effects in this deck. This deck is a straightforward play and then basically have more power over your opponent. So we're gonna go ahead and play a game. Battle, random, make sure we have the Gohan deck, and we're gonna go ahead and search. And this is your icon, so if you ever wanted to change the way your character looks or your profile looks, you can do that here. Depending on what time of the day, you'll find more players to match up with. I find around 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to it's 8 p.m. now, to about maybe midnight, it's kind of hard to find players. And it's probably due to the fact that more of the players are in Japan. So I'm fighting some guy, Weak 254, it's probably some guy in Europe. And he's got a Whistle leader card. Not looking good for me right now. So when you start off, depending on who draws first, you do a rock, paper, scissors. We got a tie. We got a tie again. All right, I win. So now normally what I like to do is I like to read his leader card. I'm gonna get rid of the Piccolo. Piccolo's 4 casting cost. I'm not gonna have 4 energy anytime soon. So let's go ahead and quickly read his Whis leader card, just because sometimes some leader cards will. So it's a blue card. Blue leader. Where is Whis? I actually had that Bills leader card. So you see over here, you start off with 2 minutes, so you have a decent amount of time to research while playing, so don't worry about that. He gets the standard attack skill. I think once per turn, place one of your energy cards in drop area, switch one level or below from your opponent's battle area, which is here, to rest mode, which is basically tap position. So he can tap my cards if he wants to, which is kind of shitty. He also has 12,000 power when flipped. Then he's gonna put his belly rest. And he can tap my cards. Basically, he can force my cards to tap. So you just gotta be wary of that in this battle. Alright, so we got one energy, 10,000, 10,000. This is a very straightforward deck. We're gonna go ahead and pop Gotenks. Then we're gonna go straight to the battle phase. We got 72 seconds. We're gonna go ahead and attack first because sometimes in the beginning I like to attack first with the leader just to see what card I draw. Alright. So what we got? We got a Bardock. There we go, Bardock. And there's no reason for me to drop Gotenks to buff him. The only way he can defend is 2 damage if he has a 0 casting cost card for 5,000 power. And we'll see here if he decides to use it or not. He doesn't. He takes 2 damage, but at the same time, remember, every time they take damage, he gets 2 energy. So he's got 2 energy now. Now, I could choose to attack him, right? But if I do and he takes the damage, he's going to have up to 4 energy next turn, allowing him to play a very powerful 4 energy card. So the fact that he's got a with leader card, let's go ahead and take a look how many games he's won. So he's only won 10 games, so actually that with card is probably luck. So we're going to go ahead and attack him. That's normally what I do to see if a player is good or not. If you click on their life button, it tells you how many games they've won. He's only won 10. So now he's thinking if he should block it or not. In my opinion, a good player would have taken that damage and dropped a level 4 bomb. Let's see, the Wisp has to get how much life? 4. So he can flip over his Wisp next turn. But remember, that was actually probably a bad move on my part because I wasn't thinking. I'm trying to explain the game. Remember, your Gohan, when your Gohan's flipped, he gets +1 strike if your opponent's life is 4 or more. Oh, for some strange reason, I thought he had 3 life, but he had 3 energy. Brain fart. Flips over Whis, right? Boom. So now he can tap my cards if he wants to. But because he's only won 10 games, I'm guessing he's been playing the game for maybe 2 or 3 days. He probably doesn't have a lot of good cards. So he drops a card from his hand to tap my card. I think all this does is prevent me from using him to add power to block. Yeah. This is going to untap during my turn. It's not a big deal. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and take the 2 damage. Because that's going to give me 2 energy. Key Blast, you see? He's got an upgraded Key Blast. That's kind of cool. So he's... I wonder if this is an account that he's just scanned extra cards into. Because the Key Blast, I think the Key Blast costs 4,000 Zenny. He's attacking for 15,000. Even if I played the Roshi, I would still get taken the damage. Now, some people like to even drop the Roshi just so that they have the energy next turn. Because if I take the damage, that's 1 energy. Drop Roshi, that's 2 energy. I'll have 5 energy next turn. When is my Gohan flip? I can flip my Gohan. Yeah, let's do it. He's got only 3 cards in his hand. I'm gonna take the damage. See the red button? I can flip my Gohan. You can flip your Gohan basically at any point in the game, whether you're defending or attacking. And some cards that is important. Some effects will only happen if you're attacking. Some effects will only happen if you're defending. I've got six. I'm gonna have six energy. I could drop these two bombs next turn, which will be kind of big for me. And it'll be big because my Gohan will be able to attack for three damage. So we've got 20,000, 15,000. So you notice that this is three to cast, but it only does one damage. This is three to cast and does two damage. So we can get rid of both these cards. So let's see, we're gonna go to the battle phase. I'm still thinking here what to do. He's got three cards in his hand, he's got no energy. So if I kill both these cards, he's gonna have two energy. However, I could force him to use them to block. So if I do this, it's gonna be two damage and he's gonna have to use one of those cards to block. So let's force his hand, right? Let's force his hand. See what happens. That's stupid of me. Hopefully he does block because, okay, thank God. So dumb. I forgot that Gohan gets plus three strike as long as he has plus four health. So he took the bait. I was planning that. He took the bait. We're gonna go ahead and flip Gohan. You're gonna click the red button and click this orange. He's gonna draw. Oh, he doesn't draw? Oh, maybe this Gohan doesn't draw. Yeah. That's lame. Let's Gohan sucks even more. Man, they give you a bad leader card. Alright, 50 seconds of battle phase. Three damage, yeah, so we definitely want... No, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna kill Krillin. The only bad thing about killing Krillin now is he's gonna have two energy. And he most likely has a two energy card in his hand to block if he wants to. But I'm gonna be drawing a card, and I can hopefully buff Gohan with this card. With zero. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and pop him. 20k. He can still block it easily. But I want the one energy for next turn for using one of these cards if I need to. He's going to take three damage. Is he insane? So now, because I buffed, I didn't have to buff Gohan, but I did. Whoa. I see more cards. I guess you can't. So it looks like, yeah, he scanned some cards. I think this Goku is in the starter deck that I showed in one of my other videos. This thing. Also, just so you know, if your time runs out on any phase, you lose the game. And if you wanted to quit the game, all you do is click on your deck icon over here. And it's going to ask you twice if you want to quit the game. So you're going to click blue both times if you wanted to quit the game for some strange reason. Alright, so what did he kill? I thought you could see the cards in your energy area. Yeah. He killed my Goku. He got two energy. He's gonna deal me two damage, so I have four mana. He tapped my card, yeah. He's got three cards in his hand, one energy. All I have to do is deal him one damage next turn. We're gonna go ahead and take two damage. Oh, by the way, I thought that Key Blast was an upgrade, but it's not. It's your standard Key Blast. Alright, so now all I have to do is deal him one damage, right? Oh, the tap. It remains tapped for the entire thing. Alright, so he's got 30,000. 30,000. 42,000 total. I have 15,000. 25,000, 35,000, 45,000. Now it all depends on him using one energy, right? To buff up his characters. Now, we're gonna try and nuke him. I mean, this is gambling. This is like what the game comes down to. And we're gonna see what happens, because even if I took out his Yamcha, right? He's gonna have two energy. And I would have to waste two cards to kill him. So now he's gonna have three energy. And he's gonna be able to nuke me next turn with three energy and all the cards in his hands. So we're gonna try and nuke him now. See, unfortunately, this deck has no like cool effect cards. It's just basically the basics of the game and math and figuring out exactly how to win. So this is actually kind of good. I wish I had a two cast card, but we should be able to pull this off. Let's see. My roommate's texting me because he wants to go to his friend's house. Now I'm hoping he doesn't have more than 55,000. Let's see. Let's see what he can pull off. 32, 42, 47. Booyah! We won with the basic Gohan deck. So every time you win, it tells you how many times you won over here. Now what these buttons are, this basically brings you back to the main area of the game. This button over here lets you continue battling if you want. And this button here, if you want to add this guy to your friends list, and if you do, you click on the blue button and it says it sends a request. The reason why this is important, how many times you win or play, is because if you go to the digital items area, you can only buy some items here, like have locks and stuff like that. So we're gonna go ahead and click on the lock. This basically says you need to win 30 random games, right? So I've won 20 so far because I reinstalled the game. And this basically says Ato 10 wins. So I have 10 more wins to do. There will be some other items that say you just need to play games. But I think most of them are basically you have to win. Yeah, so that's why these are locked, is because you have to win or play a certain amount of games. And the bottom option here, I guess, is the more important one, is basically how many more you need to play or win. And then basically the top is telling you the total amount. But after you do win and play the game, those games, you have to then have the amount of Zenny to purchase the item. So if I wanted to purchase any of these icons to change my character icon, I would need 4,000 Zenny, and I do. So that is the Gohan the Gohan deck, the standard deck that you get when you first start off the game. I might make some more videos on playing with the Gohan deck. I might actually stream it, just because I'd rather hear people ask questions on why I'm doing certain things versus me playing the game and talking about it. So subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I will be streaming this game. I prefer streaming on YouTube versus Twitch, just because I like the YouTube community. So stay tuned. I will be making some other videos playing the game using the other leader cards that I have. And I will be making videos opening packs. I got two booster boxes. I also have a rare Vegeta leader card that came with a magazine. I will show you guys basically The deck that comes in here with the Goku leader card. So I'll probably make a video next on with this Goku leader card. Just because most of you who are watching these videos will probably go to Amazon and buy this for 20, 30 bucks. So you can scan cards. And another cool thing is every time you scan a card, you get Zenny. So stay tuned, subscribe. And I gotta drop my friend off at his house because he does not have a car. So until then, ja matane. Actually, if you've seen my other two videos, how to install and then how to play, I'm making these videos back to back just because it's really annoying setting up all the audio equipment because for some strange reason when I shut everything down, it doesn't work, so I have to spend a few hours. Anyway, I've been talking a lot and I'm very parched and I almost need another drink. Anyway, you don't want to hear me talk about that.